Good morning, and young people, I hope you'll come and join me here at the altar for a special time together with you. Today we begin the season of Lent together as a church, and you might say, well, what's Lent? What is Lent all about, and what are we celebrating? And this time of the year, as we look at Lent, it's 40 days before Jesus, and we meet him on the cross. And so we take this journey of Lent, these 40 days, and we read the stories of what happened before he finds himself at the cross. And we travel with the disciples, and we read some of those stories throughout this time together. The season of Lent also is usually marked with the color purple. So our tablecloth at the altar today is purple, and it has circles in it and other little symbols that kind of look like crosses. And it helps us to be mindful of the season that we're in. And purple is a color that's often been associated with passion. And so it's the color in the church that we use for the season of Lent. So what I have underneath the cross is something that is called the grief cycle. And with each of these words we are going to look at during the season of Lent and the grief cycle to help us walk this 40-day journey with Jesus. So each of these words remind me of stories of what Jesus went through, but it also reminds me of what we sometimes go through, and especially what we're going through and have been for almost a whole year with COVID, and that is grief. And often when we think of grief, we instantly think that it's related to somebody who has died, and it certainly is. But it also relates to things that are about change or loss. So if we just look at this grief cycle for a minute, think about the news of when maybe your parents told you about the virus, or your parents told you, actually, you can't go to school anymore. You have to stay home, and you have to do school on the computer. And with that, at the very top, you might have felt a bit shocked, like you couldn't believe it. What are they talking about, this virus? What am I hearing a little bit about on the news? And what do they mean that I can't go to school and see my friends and visit my neighbor? What do you mean we can't have people over at our house anymore? What do you mean we can't go visit our grandparents because we might get them sick or they'll get us sick? And we all felt really shocked. We couldn't believe this was happening to us. And so that's part of what happens is with news or with change or with something we really can't control, we feel shocked. And it doesn't kind of matter what order you experience or feel these things, but we all feel and experience these things. One of the things that might have happened at some point is you might have got really angry. You said, I'm so mad, I can't go to school. This isn't fair, you might have said to your parents. You're not fair, you're not treating me fair. It might have led to a place where you felt really angry. You might have had a time where you participated in bargaining, where you said to your parents, or you might have said to God, well, if I do this, then can this thing stop? If I do this, can I go back to school? If I'm really careful, can I go see my friends? If I put my mask on, and some of the answers to that bargaining or trying to beg your parents for something might have ended up in a no response from them. And it doesn't seem to matter what we try to do. We can't fix or change something. And that's what bargaining really means. You might have gone through a time where you felt really sad. And you might have cried or stayed in your bed a bit longer during the day because you just didn't want to face or deal with what was happening in the world or the news of the virus or not being able to see friends or other things. And that's really natural to go through each and every one of these, to be in shock, in disbelief, anger, bargaining, and sadness. And at some point in time, after we experience all of those different emotions, most of us try to get to a place where we say, okay, I accept this is the way it's going to be. And when we get to that place, we feel a bit more calm and we begin to understand the things that are being said to us. And we say, okay, I don't really like being online for school, but I'm going to get up this morning and that's what I need to do today. And that's when we get to a place of acceptance. And so through this season of Lent, we're going to walk this cycle of grief together and learn more of what it means. And hopefully it will help us go through whatever changes or whatever we're experiencing now to get and to arrive at a place of acceptance again. Thank you for joining me here, and thank you for being with us today. And we do hope and pray that you are well, even in the midst of what we are all experiencing together.